you, Madam Speaker. The community of Burgersdale has been making headlines highlighting service delivery crisis, but still the government of Gauteng has done nothing to improve their living conditions. The former Premier, Nomvula Mokonyane, belittled this community on numerous occasions and even said that the ANC doesn't need their dirty vote. Yet today we're sitting here and the current Premier, David Makhura and MEC Mamabolo, went to Western Area over the weekend to undermine this community even further by doing a dummy handover of 17 houses to further their political agenda of pacifying citizens. This clearly means that dirty vote is equivalent to 17 houses. The current living conditions in Burgersdale are in dire straits. Throughout the 20-year rule of the ANC in Gauteng, the switch and network hasn't been attended to. Some of the residents are still using the pit toilets and the infrastructure doesn't exist at all, as most buildings have been vandalized. Like other municipalities in Gauteng, corruption has been institutionalized and legalized through the protection of incumbents from prosecution and investigation. In order to reduce the dependency on the current state tender system, the EFF has identified the dire need for a state housing construction company that will improve quality and size of low-cost housing. The state, at all levels, should have the obligation to provide sanitation wherever people reside. This is a fundamental human right, which should lead to the abolishment of bucket and pit toilet. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Honorable Disulwane is not here. Honorable Ntobin.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Dumelang Lord Khamontlung. Madam Speaker, I stand here sadly because as I stand here, I believe that everyone is looking forward to the festive season, Christmas, and a very happy new year. But that is not the case for a certain Gogo at Dobsonville, Gogo Miriam, who has been evicted from her house, from her parents' house. She's been living there since 1957. They were moved from Durban Deep to Dobsonville. She lives in Dobsonville with a blind son who's 53 years old and a daughter with four grandchildren. Ugog Miriam has been the sole provider, a caregiver and financial provider to that household, and yet she's also appearing in the permit. There's a permit and there's a title deed. She's appearing there, but someone was able to sell the house through the corruption that is happening in the city council led by the ANC. The house was sold while she's still living in it. Yesterday I went to see her. I found that she's living on a pavement next to the Dobsonville police station. I ask, where is Ubuntu in this regard? Butubukai, little ruling party. I'm talking to the people on the far right there. Yes, on the far right. It is the far right. Butubukai, Nembeza. Your private army. How does that happen? She is 68 years old. So she is old. So please, I beg of you, while you are sitting, drinking your expensive whiskey, flying on first class and business classes to your destinations, think of it. Just imagine That is the statement that you need to know. I'm telling you, you need to know. You must think about what is she eating, where is she sleeping. To the ANC, this is the season for giving. You've taken enough for so long. Eban Meletswalo. Thank you.
Honorable Sampen.